Hey groupies, welcome back to Form Therapy. I am the video channel producer, you can call me PD, and today we are doing a listening party for TXT's debut EP. It is called The Dream Chapter Star. Now, we checked out Crown, it was fun, and we're going to be checking out their four other B-sides, Blue Orangeade, Our Summer, Cat and Dog, and Nap of a Star. Now, I don't know what to expect going in. Obviously, Crown was just one song, it was refreshing, it felt youthful, and it was a fun pop song, but that doesn't mean that's what everything else on this album is going to be, so we'll jump into it and find out. But before we start, we actually put up a poll on the TXT Amino and Twitter to see what people would think my favorite B-side is going to be. So everyone voted. I haven't seen the results yet. We're going to reveal it at the end of the video. And if you're watching this later on YouTube, obviously the polls have already happened. You can't vote anymore, but you know, you can play along yourself. Just kind of make an assumption. What do you think is going to be my favorite B-side? And then let me know in the comments down below if at the end of the video, when I tell you what my favorite B-side is, let me know if it matched up with your predictions. Let's just jump right into it. We'll start with Blue Orangeade. Why does this sound like a 90s R&B song? Even with the harmonizing, like, voice in the background, like, ooh. Oh, I feel like there wasn't this kind of a rap break in Crown. I'm gonna be honest, this is not what I expected it to sound like. I would love to see the choreo for this. Okay, that song is very weird. Like I said, we've only heard Crown so far, and listening to Crown and then listening to this, this is not what you would expect from this group. First of all, I think the sound is a lot more mature compared to Crown. Listening to Crown, I got a lot more of a very youthful vibe off of them. This one, they don't sound like grandpas or anything, but this one just sounds a lot more mature, a lot more slicker and smoother. And what I find more surprising is that the actual sound of this sounds like an American song from like late 90s. It has that kind of fun R&B feel that was very prevalent. In K-pop, we're going through a cycle through nostalgia, and the 90s has been hitting for a while. And some people have been doing 90s R&B for the past half a year, year, something like that. So far, I like Blue Orangeade. I think the rap break was actually really interesting because was there a rap break in Crown? Even if there was a rap break in Crown, I feel like the rap break in Blue Orangeade is a lot more dynamic and interesting. Someone said the majority of the main producers for Star are American. Ooh, interesting. That might be why there is such a heavy American influence sound on this first song. But let's get into the second song. This is Our Summer. Okay, so this one is also very different from Crown and Blue Orangeade. Very light, feels very airy and open. Hold on. Hold on. I don't know if I like this yet. I'm waiting for something. Okay, here is why I had to wait and listen to the entire song to gauge how I feel about this. Not that I didn't like it in the beginning. I was not satisfied in the beginning. The first chorus, for me, it felt like it was supposed to be a two-part chorus, and it felt like they suddenly cut off the second part. I was like, wait a minute, what? And then the second chorus comes along, and then they have the extended instrumental part that they add into the chorus that plays as the two-part hook, and then they use it again in the third chorus as well. That makes it a lot better. That's what I was waiting for, basically. I was waiting for, is there a second extension to the chorus? Now, people are saying it's such a summer song, but it's not a regular summer song. Like, first of all, I feel like most summer songs and most formulas for summer songs are meant to be really exciting and fun and very energetic. You know, they've got loud, incredible drops, but this is nothing like that. I think what makes our summer different, and you have to kind of listen to it in a different context. You can't see it as like, oh, it's a summer song, because then you have like this weird expectation of like Mamamoo's egotistic or something like that, you know? This isn't that kind of summer song. This is the kind of summer song where sums up the summer, if that makes sense. Maybe like summer's ending. Maybe you just graduated high school and it's your last summer together with your friends before everybody moves away, and it's the song that plays over the montage as you're going to the airport and you're remembering like your final summer with your friends. It's a summer song that's also very nostalgic. Like, it's a little bit romantic in its mood. And I'm not talking like romance as in love, love. The romance of life, you know? The romance of life, they say, you have to have heartbreak and you have to have heartache. You have to have pain. That way, when you feel something good, it feels that much better. If you didn't feel heartbreak, you would never feel joy, you know? And that's sort of what our summer feels like. You had this amazing summer with somebody, maybe a group of friends, maybe a lover, who knows? And you go into that summer knowing that it's going to end in heartache. It's going to end in heartbreak. It's going to end with you guys parting ways. But you sort of enter this unspoken agreement to basically break each other's hearts, because to have spent time with that person, to have spent the summer with that person, is better than not having spent the summer with them at all. And it has that really great kind of like teen coming of age indie cinema movie feel. So I really like it. Who hurt you, PD? Life. All right, let's get into Cat and Dog. Feel like I'm your cat, I'm your dog. 내 두 눈은 너밖에 안 보여. 우리 사이 무연 아니면 연. 나는 너만 있으면. I don't wanna be a friend. 너를 주기 싫은 너와 can I be a pet. 24시간을 계속해서 네 옆에. 별을 자르. Can I be your pet? Excuse me? Okay, I know that's not what he's saying, but it sounds like he's saying Neopets. Whoa, that's weird. Oh, fuck, this is good though. So he's saying Neope, which is by your side, but it just sounds like Neopets. That's a weird song, man. I will say, all of their songs are very different. If we lay it down to its most simplest terms, the most basic terms, if we break it down, I like it just based on the beat. I like the flow. Let's say if you were to like, say there are unit groups within the group, right? Like a dance team, a vocal team, a hip hop team. Our Summer is like the dance team slash performance team type song. You know, it's very light and breezy. Cat and Dog is the more hip hop team type song, you know? It tries to be like a hip hop song. It tries to be like a rap song. It is, but the lyrics just make it so weird. I'm in shock. I'm still processing. But like I said, Crown has such a very youthful vibe to it. When watching Crown, I thought, oh, they're boys, right? But Cat and Dog, it feels a lot more like they're trying to be grown up. It seems like they're trying to be a lot more masculine, you know, especially with the vocal ad-libs of the barking, like the oh, oh. It sounds very aggressive, you know? It's so weird that they can do multiple different styles like this. But I like it. I'll admit, I like it. The lyrics are weird, but I like it. Let's check out the last song. This is Nap of a Star. All right, does anybody get, like, is anyone else getting, like, Christian youth vibes? I imagine them up on a podium in, like, a Christian youth center singing this. You get a Band of Horses vibe? Maybe the guitar has like a Band of Horses vibe, but not the vocals and not the arrangement. Praise the Lord, y'all. Sounds like Bon Iver. Okay, I hear that. I do hear that. Part where they pluck at the chord, dun, 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 dun. It travels from one headphone to the other like this. Very interesting. Okay, so Nap of a Star. People thought I wouldn't like it because I don't like ballads, but I don't really consider Nap of a Star a ballad, especially with like the soul, like tar accompaniment. Like it feels, you know, someone in the chat was saying like it feels very Bon Iver, very Band of Horses. And yeah, it feels more like American indie music more than it feels like a Korean ballad song, you know? What I don't like about Korean ballad songs is how typical and generic it is. Honestly, if you compare this to like any Korean OST soundtrack, they don't sound remotely similar in the least. I think the best way to frame it is if you re-listen to this song, but you imagine someone with a very different voice and they're singing in English, like imagine Birdie singing this, imagine Bon Iver singing this, imagine any of those indie bands singing this, you would never say this is a ballad, you know? It's just because it's Korean and it's slow and it makes you assume that it's a ballad song. It's not. It sounds like an American indie song. A lot of this album has a very heavy American influence, and TXT obviously brings the K-pop twist to it, but I'm actually really surprised. I think they do a great job at setting themselves apart from BTS very, very much. You know, I was wondering because they're from the same label, you know, obviously it's different producers because BTS, they work on their own music with the help of Pang PD, but I was curious as to whether or not they were going to sound similar, and they don't sound similar at all. They have a very distinct sound. They're very experimental, and in terms of my favorite song, on a personal level, my favorite song is Our Summer. I think the catchiest song is Cat and Dog, but I think Our Summer, it's a lot more emotional, in my opinion. There's something underneath the surface about it that's a little bit more special. I think Cat and Dog is a lot catchier, and I think Cat and Dog is a lot more memorable, but I would say that Our Summer is my favorite. Our Summer, Cat and Dog, Blue Orangeade, and then Nap of a Star. I would say Cat and Dog is second for me. Anyways, guys, thank you for tuning into the TXT listening party. I think TXT is extremely talented, and listening to this, I don't feel fulfilled enough. Like, I am ready to listen to like a whole full-length album. Yeah, I need more from TXT, and whenever they have another comeback, I will be there. Anyways, thanks guys for joining us for this listening party. I'll see you in the next video. Peace.